Bismillah, walhamdulillahi, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulullah, sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ahlihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon the seal of the prophets and the leader of the messengers, ar-rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him and upon his household and entire companions. Dear viewers, I greet you all with the best of greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. And you're welcome to another episode of The Reminders. Inshallah, on today's episode, this is a three-part episode. We'll be talking about one of the greatest events in the life of the Muslims and in the life precisely of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and this was the event of Al-Isra wal Miraj. And to talk about this event, subhanallah, it's so powerful and so impactful that we had to make this outdoor, and we had to come to this beautiful garden, subhanallah, that makes it, you know, makes us visualize some of the narrations I will be giving to us all bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Now, this event of Al-Isra wal Miraj was one that happened in the life of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It was after the death of his uncle Abu Talib and also the death of his wife Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, and after the incident in At-Ta'if. Now, if we all remember this incident, it was a very remarkable incident in the life of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, because after the death of his uncle, one who had protected him, one who had stood by him, one who had ensured that, you know, none of the Quraishi pagans would chastise him beyond what was necessary, and at the time of his death, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam urging his uncle to utter the words of testification, the kalimat al-shahada, at which his uncle could not utter, and he died not believing in Islam, even though he believed, yes, that his nephew was a righteous person and his nephew was on the right and telling the truth, but he didn't accept Islam. And for this reason, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam was saddened by this, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the verse that innaka la tahdi man ahbabt walakin Allah yahdi man yasha, that verily it is not for you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, to guide whomever you love or guide whomever you wish, but it is Allah that guides whom He wills. And at the same time, his wife Khadija, the one who had protected and also protected him and the one who had supported him throughout his mission, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also took her life from this world and she returned to him. And this year was known as the year of sorrow for the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam when this particular incident happened. And following that was also the incident in Ta'if. Now, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam went to Ta'if to do da'wah and to call the people there to Islam, especially the chiefs and especially those that were regarded as the elites in the society. But these so-called elites became, you know, they were filled with arrogance and they sent him away and asked him to leave. And upon that, they also unleashed children upon him who were carrying stones and stoning the blessed Prophet of Islam sallallahu alayhi wasallam until he went unconscious in one narration, and in one narration until he began to bleed from his face. And when this happened, Malaikal Jibreel came, and another angel also who was there with him, saying that these are the mountains that give me the permission to crush this community for what they have done. But the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam didn't do this. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam instead raised his cries to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, Allahumma inni ashku ilayka da'fa quwwati, that, O Allah, I complain to none other than yourself about the weakness I suffer from, that I have no strength. But we knew the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam to be devoid of this. He was the most brave, he was the most conscious, he was strong when it came to a lot of things that he did, as we have studied in his seerah. But this particular incident that occurred with the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam was one that would be the preempter of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had caused to happen, and this was the journey of Al-Isra wal Mi'raj, a journey which sounds like something out of a sci-fi or fantasy movie, but this is a miraculous event that happened in the lifetime of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and it is something that when we study the seerah, the significance of this was that it strengthened him and strengthened the Muslim community as well to know that this is a messenger truly from the Creator, the Sustainer, Rabbul Alameen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who has created the heavens and the earth, the one who has fashioned man to be the way he is, the one who created all things, and he didn't seek for anyone's permission and he didn't seek for anyone's partnership in his creation. This is Allah Azza wa Jal, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused for this journey to happen to further strengthen the heart of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam and also strengthen the resolve of the believers as as well. On the next episode, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, we'll talk about this, or the beginning of this great journey, which has such a great impact and significance in the life of the Muslims and in the entire universe as well, because this was something that never occurred between the prophets that came before, and it was something that further showed that Islam would be the final message to the final messenger and the final message to us all as human beings. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.